I get asked a lot about supplements, and it's a really big and sometimes even confusing topic. And in addition, there are so many ads that come to us all the time on social media, either clear ads where someone's, you know, pushing a vitamin, or soft ads where an influencer is just talking about it off the cuff and you don't actually know if it was paid for or not.
Like, if you want to optimize your health, yeah, right. Supplements are very beneficial.
Very beneficial, but I think for you and me it's a duh, but I think.
So the truth is, there are very few supplements that have good evidence-based medicine to support them. And the term supplement is really meant to be a dietary supplement, meaning something that is supplementing a dietary shortfall. The greatest example is probably prenatal vitamins. There is good evidence-based medicine to support using prenatal vitamins because the average person doesn't get enough folate and other micronutrients in their diet to support a real healthy pregnancy. Another common one is if you have iron deficiency anemia. It's really hard to get enough iron from your diet to treat that, and so we might recommend an iron supplement. So those are what we would consider sort of the kind of evidence-based examples, and that is not an inclusive list, but that's how to think about it. Then there's this other class of supplements, meaning a reported medical benefit. Although in the United States, supplement companies can't actually say their product does anything. They all have these little FDA disclaimers. But that might be some things that are grounded in pretty good science, or good science even. So magnesium to treat constipation. But there's also things that aren't grounded in good science, like black cohosh for hot flashes. Another common one that we see all the time is biotin for hair growth, but there's no data to support that. So there's a wide range of things that are potentially have good science behind them and things that have no science behind them, and things that might be kind of in between. And then there are another category of supplements where there's a whole bunch of vitamins and minerals and herbals and botanicals all lumped together in a product where there is an insinuation that there's some kind of benefit for your organ or for your health, or like ovary support or adrenal support or thyroid support or metabolism booster or fat burner. And none of these are studied in any meaningful way. And many of them are actually adulterated. And that is one big concern with supplements, is you do not know what you are getting. So how do you decide? Three ways to think about supplements. One, is this something you really need to take? Is there good evidence to support it? Well, you want to ask your doctor if the supplement you want to take falls in a good recommendation. Or places to look would be the CDC, Centers for Disease Control. If it's for a reproductive health issue, it might be the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. And also in the US government has the Office of Dietary Supplements. Number two, who is recommending this to you? Is it someone who's selling a product, or is this someone saying, these are the recommendations of multiple medical societies? So look at the source of the recommendation. And number three, you want to take a product that has been tested by a third party. For example, a USP verified label means that there's been third party checking. That's really the best that we can do, because in the United States, we don't have the ability of the government to require testing for purity. And be very wary about Ayurvedic products, because they are actually very likely to be contaminated with lead. About 20% of them are, especially with products that are for libido, for metabolism, for sport enhancement. Those products have a much higher risk of contamination. This is a huge problem, and it's important because, one, you want to make sure that the product you're taking isn't contaminated with heavy metals or mold or fungi or things like that, but you also want to make sure it contains what it claims. And that's actually why pharmaceuticals have a standard, so none of these things happen. They get tested, and that doesn't happen with supplements.
Want to dive deeper? Become a Big Think member and join our members-only community, watch videos early, and unlock full interviews.